Hey everyone, welcome to our channel Java Beam, and this is Satya. In this video I'm going to explain about interfaces. So here you are going to learn about interface definition and signature, and what is the use of interface, and how we have to implement the interface, and what is the method, what are the things we can provide inside interface, and we are also going to learn about tag interfaces. Let me jump to write some code. So before that, like, what exactly is the interface? Interface, we can say it is a 100% abstract class. Yeah, in interface we can provide variables and methods. We are not going to discuss about the advanced feature or in advanced version like Java 8 and 9. There are numerous changes in interface behavior. Like, we can provide a static method or default methods or private methods, but we are not going to discuss about all these. Just we are discussing about the basic behavior and how we implement the interface. Those things we are going to learn. So let me create an interface. So to create an interface, we need to use a keyword called interface, and here I'm giving a interface name is demo. Here you can see the signature. This is the keyword we have to use to create interface. Like, for class, we use a class keyword to create the class. Similar way, we use the interface keyword to create the interface. And interface, this is a default public we have to provide for a top level interface. And in interface, we can provide variables. Those are like a static constraints. And we can provide abstract methods. And what is the use of this interface? So interface provides the 100% abstraction, so that we can expose the API to outside world, and if somebody want to interact with your services, they can implement the interfaces and they can interact with your services. For example, JDBC API, that has been like most of the features are interfaces, and there are very few classes. So like JDBC vendors, they have to implement the JDBC API to interact their JDBC their applications with JDBC or Java applications. For example, Oracle or Sybase or MySQL, these are database providers. These are the vendors to our Java application or JDBC API. They have implemented drivers based on the JDBC API so that our applications they can interact with our JDBC. Using JDBC API, they can interact with our Java applications. So JDBC API is the interface here, and Java application is consuming that JDBC API. And the implemented party is from database vendors like Oracle. So there is a communication between Oracle database to our Java class. The medium is JDBC API. Yeah. And as we discussed here, we can provide a variable which are constants. Let's say I am providing user ID. Let's say some number. And its type is int. So interface variables are by default public, static, and final. By default means like we no need to provide this one. If you didn't provide, also Java compiler, while compiling our interface, it will add to our interface. And if you provide also provide this, doesn't make any difference and doesn't give any problem. And for the methods are like by default abstract and public. Let's say I'm creating one method, test. So I'm not providing any method body here because the interface doesn't allow to provide any method body, and we need to keep semicolon. And methods are by default public and abstract. even though if you won't provide, doesn't matter. It's, if you provide also, it won't give you any issue. And one more thing, interface can provide multiple inheritance. Like you can extend multiple interfaces, like clonable I want to extend, and runnable I want to extend. I can extend multiple interfaces in comma separated. So in classes, Java doesn't provide multiple inheritance, but in coming to interfaces, Java provides multiple inheritance. So you can use this feature if you want to extend multiple interfaces, but still you cannot provide any body here. Only thing is you can declare the methods, and the implemented classes can provide the body. And one more thing, interfaces I can provide without any body. Such interfaces are called tagged interfaces. There are many tagged interfaces available in Java. Let's see, one of the tagged interfaces is clonable. So this interface doesn't have any methods or variables. It's empty interface. This is used for cloning our classes, our objects. So if you want to clone any object, you have the first increment clonable, then only it can be used. So this class are this interface are called tagged interface or marker interfaces. Those doesn't have any methods or variables. Yeah. Let me implement this interface. Yeah, these are not required for us. So I am implementing this interface in a class. This class name demo IMPL. Inside this class, I need to use like implement and demo. Yeah, and one more thing you can observe here, you cannot use extends keyword. Class cannot extend a interface, only interface can extend other interfaces. Only interface can extend other interfaces, and class can only implement the interfaces. And if you are not providing the implementation for your methods, then this class should be declared as abstract. Otherwise, it will be a compilation error. See, here you can see, you should provide a body. Must implement the inherited abstract method test. Yeah, let me implement that method test. That signature we have, whatever we have given there, we need to use that signature and we have to provide the body. So the body we will provide inside the braces. This is a method body we are going to provide. So let me just give some string interface implementation, something like this. So this is like now 100% implemented class. If any class is not 100% implemented to interface, then that should be a abstract. As we discussed, like let's say I'm not implementing this one, then I need to save this class as abstract, then it's valid. But as I'm providing the body for a method, interface method, this can be a 100% non-abstract class. And let me create like a creation part, like a, let's say I have main method. I can use the behavior of interface abstraction, like demo obj equal to new demo IMPL, and obj can call the implemented method. So here, this is the implementation part. This is a interface implemented class, and this is the interface. So here you can see the inheritance behavior. like demo interface can refers to the implemented. Let's say I have one more class which is also implementing the demo interface, demo impl2, and this is implementing demo. Here I am providing the method body for the test method. Let me give some print statement here. So demo impl2, something like this. So here in this main method, instead of let's say in future if I want to change the implemented class to other class, I can give the other class without changing the other behaviors, other rest of the things, because the reference is interface and implemented part is whatever here. So this part is not changing because this is referring to the implemented demo impl2, also implemented a demo interface. That's the reason demo object or reference can refers to implemented class, and we can call the implemented method. Now my demo interface is pointing to implemented class demo impl2. That's the reason we can see the output here is from demo2 class. Let's say I'm going for demo1, but the output we'll see the output from demo impl1 method. Here this is a demo impl1 implemented method. This is how we can use the interfaces in our project. There might be tens or twenties of classes which can implement the base interfaces, as interface is providing abstraction, only declare the methods and variables. And how can we use this variable outside? As this is a static variable and this is a final variable, variable cannot be changed, and the whole life the variable value will be remain same. And we can access this value using direct class name, because these are the static, something like this we can access. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and please do subscribe my channel. If you want to learn any concepts, please provide in below comment section so that I can make a video on that. Bye for now, signing off.